If they do not want to be held in contempt, I do not want anyone to take pictures of anybody if you are not member of the media. I'd like to provide a holding room for the victims alone. And for the record, hindi lang po ako human rights advocate. Ako din po ay anti-illegal drugs advocate. I do not believe that you must choose between one or the other. While we would like to arrest and put in prison all of the drug peddlers, we would like to give compassion to the drug users who are also victims of these drugs. And we want them to be rehabilitated. Ang nakapagtataka dito, bakit yung mga drug lords at mga drug traffickers na kayayaman, hindi napapatay? Kayong mga generals, alam niyo yan, nakakulong at ginagamit pa ang kulungan bilang opisina to peddle on drugs. That is what we're after here. Bakit ang napapatay yung mga may hirap? Bakit ang napapatay yung hindi kaya mag-hire ng mga magaling na abogado?
There are some police people that are taking pictures on them. If they do not want to be held in contempt, I do not want anyone to take pictures of anybody if you are not member of the media. I'd like to provide a holding room for the victims alone. But first of all, I'd like to congratulate a good friend, a judge from Manila, who is now the director of the National Bureau of Investigation. Congratulations. Palapakan natin. All right. I'm so glad that finally we have been able judge to be director of the NBI. We also would like to recognize Representative Edward Maceda in the Zoom today. So, to all my colleagues and fellow members of the committee, ang mga resource persons po natin, na our guests that are with us today, ganda umaga po sa inyo lahat. As we convene for the fourth hearing of our inquiry into the alleged extrajudicial killings that occurred during the war on drugs of the previous administration, I wish to reiterate the guiding principles that underscore our proceedings, our quest for justice. As I've said yesterday, I am for the war on drugs. What I'm against is how it was done. What I'm against is when we have human rights violations. What I'm against is in a democratic country we have, that we are being ruled by the bullet of the gun. Now, pinakita po natin dito na mayroong human rights violations. All right? Pero gusto kong sabihin sa lahat na ayaw natin ng drugs sa ating bansa. We want peace. And I have called on you people today. All right? Yesterday, nagkaroon kami ng hearing sa mga biktima. At nakita namin na ako, sabihin ko sa inyo, palagay ko hindi nagsasabi ng kasinungalingan itong mga taon to. They are weeping, they're crying, nag-peace yung mga yan, and they want justice. Sapagkat ang iba sa kanila, mistaken identity, minor de edad, drug user. Yung mga drug user na ito, kahit ng pedaya, kakampihan ako nito, hindi nila kailangan hulihin eh. Kailangan rehabilitate yung mga yan. Yung drug user. Yung peddling drugs, nais kong sabihin sa inyo, mga abogadong iba sa inyo, mga kapulisan kayo, ha? Naniniwala tayo that an accused is presumed innocent until proven guilty. Ayaw natin, dumating ang panahon na gagamitin ng mga pulis ang kanilang mga baril instead of obeying the rule of law. Kaya meron tayong hearing na ganito. And I would want to request that everyone ought to respect this hearing. This might not be a court, but this is
a committee hearing by the Congress of the Philippines. Meron tayong batas po dito. And I do not want anyone to make a mockery of this hearing. Just to let you know about that, okay? Nais natin na maging mahusay po tayo rito. Kaya pinatawag po natin, kahit na yung hindi lang yung mga biktima, kahit na yung mga alleged na nandun sa panahong yan, na inaakusahan sila na sila po ay pumatay o nagbigay ng paintulot na patayin ang mga taong ito. So ito po ang ibig sabihin ng community hearing na ito. Yesterday, we focus on the families of the victims to allow us to hear their stories in full. As we have said from the beginning, we want to hear all sides of the issue. Balansin po natin ito. Okay? We do not want to be biased on one side. We want to hear all sides of the issue. So today, we will be focusing on the perspective of the state actors, those who were tasked with implementing the war on drugs. I will state this again. It is imperative that we maintain fairness and impartiality, ensuring that all sides are heard. This is essential for the integrity of our inquiry. This is vital if we want to obtain true justice. During these hearings, we do not want to downplay the threat posed by illegal drugs. We recognize that illegal drugs are a significant problem in our society. The scourge of illegal narcotics has ruined lives and destroyed families. This representation believes it is a challenge that continues to demand decisive action. And for the record, hindi lang po ako human rights advocate. Ako din po ay anti-illegal drugs advocate. I do not believe that you must choose between one or the other. While we would like to arrest and put in prison all of the drug peddlers, we would like to give compassion to the drug users who are also victims of these drugs. And we want them to be rehabilitated. Ang nakapagtataka dito, bakit yung mga drug lords at mga drug traffickers na kayayaman, hindi napapatay? Oh, kayong mga generals, alam niyo yan, nakakulong at ginagamit pa ang kulungan bilang opisina to peddle on drugs. That is what we're after here. Bakit ang napapatay yung mga may hirap? Bakit ang napapatay yung hindi kaya mag-hire ng mga magaling na abogado? Yun po ang pinag-ataka ko eh. Di ba? I mean, lahat tayo, nakikita po natin ito. Hanggang ngayon, nawawala na ba yung drug trafficker sa atin? Hindi. Sapagkat kung wala na lahat yan, baka wala ng drugs yun sa atin. Pero bakit sa 2 taon ng current administration, marami pa rin nahuhuling drugs? And this time, they're smuggled. Ibig sabihin, dumadaan sa Bureau of Customs yan. Lumalabas. Sinong umahawak niyan? Kaya't alam niyo mga kaibigan, hindi ho matatapos ang hearing na ito. At ipinangako ko kahapon, tatapusin po natin ito. Anuman ang mangyari. Alright. So, our desire to save lives must go hand in hand with the respect for the lives of everyone, including the accused. Oo. These are the foundations of our democracy, and they must guide all our actions as a state. The House Committee on Human Rights is leading these hearings because it is our duty to ensure that justice is served. Bakit po kami, kahit na recess ang Kongreso, dapat ako po'y nasa
distrito ko. Oo, upang makipagkita naman sa mga constituent ko. Nandito ako ngayon. Kailangan eh. 'Di ba? Kailangan po natin ito. All right. Duty natin to ensure that justice is served, not just through the enforcement of laws, but to the upholding of the values that define us as a nation. Our actions must reflect our commitment to fairness, accountability, and respect for human dignity. Gusto ko lang sagutin ang isang basher natin sa pahayagan na nagsasabi, o bakit pati ang Kongreso iniimbisigahan to? Bakit hindi ipaubaya sa executive branch of government? Sasabihin ko po sa inyo, the executive cannot implement any laws because the laws are being made in Congress. Hindi po pwedeng gumalaw ang Pangulo ng Pilipinas na hindi naaayon sa batas at ang batas ginagawa sa Kongreso. Hindi ginagawa kung saan-saan. Yan ang gusto kong makita po ninyo. Oo. Kaya nga po in aid of legislation to eh. We would like to see the rules of engagement of the Philippine National Police. Nasunod ba ito? Yung batas na dapat meron tayong due process, nasunod po ba ito? Ito ba'y sinunod ng ating ilang mga law enforcers? Hindi ko nilalahat ang Philippine National Police. Kakampi ho natin yan sa peace and order. Alam po yan ng ating mga general. Kung paano kahit ako, kung mayroong human rights violation sa loob ng kapulisan, iimbisigan natin yan. Alright? So before wrapping up, I would like to thank my colleagues here for their dedication and hard work, particularly for continuing to work through the rest, to the recess na ginagamit po natin. Your commitment emphasizes the importance of these hearings and our collective responsibility to seek the truth. Again, let us proceed mindful of the gravity of the issues before us and the lives that have been affected. Kaya maraming salamat po sa inyo lahat. Before anything else, again, I would like to state, ano po, I will not hesitate to use the powers of this committee to hold in contempt and even to arrest those people are taking pictures here. No one can take pictures inside or outside if you are not part of the media. Gusto ko lang po sabihin sa inyo. Now, as we continue on, I would like any of my colleagues to please make a motion to extend the conduct of this inquiry.
Mr. Chair?
Yes, Congressman Ako.
Pursuant to Section 15 of our Rules on Inquiry, may respectfully move that we extend the hearing of this issue. So move, Mr. Chair.
Second motion, Mr. Chair.
There is a motion and a second that we continue on with the conduct of this inquiry. Do I hear any? All right. Hearing no objection. Same as approved. I'd like to recognize Representative Joseph Stephen Caraspaduano, also, I think, in the Zoom today. All right.
Mr. Chair.
Yes, Congressman Ako.
Before we proceed with the interpellation proper, may I be allowed to ask whether deliverables in the last hearing were complied with? For example, we have for the PNP, have they submitted a detailed report on the status of all 28 invited officers, delineating those who are AWOL, retired or active in service? May I know if the PNP has complied with this requirement?
May I answer, Mr. Chair?
Yes, General Pena.
Mr. Chair, we have here our a report of all the requirements. We will submit this formally to the committee, Mr. Chair.
So you have not submitted it yet?
Not yet, Mr. Chair.
For the information of everybody, if in the last hearing you were submitted to submit such a requirement, it should be given or submitted 3 days before the 3 days before the next hearing. Alam nyo kung bakit? Kasi kailangan mabasa rin naman namin. Kung ibibigay nyo lang ngayon, hindi na namin mababasa. Kasi nandito na po tayo eh. The other requirement, Mr. Chair, for the PNP, and I think it's from letter A to N, they were required to clarify what actions PNP has taken regarding AWOL personnel and the current status of retired officers.
Anyone among the PNP would like to answer that? Yeah, General Hernia.
I don't have the report, Mr. Chair, but we can prepare a report regarding that issue, Mr. Chair.
Letter C is submit PNP internal cleansing report, interim and final reports signed by former Chief General Albayalde. Nandito po ba kayo in the last hearing?
Mr. Chair, I was not around during the last...
And may I know who was the representative of the Philippine National Police then?
From the DPRA, Mr. Chair, it was Attorney Hyacinth Santos.
And he did not say anything about the requirements needed from your office?
Mr. Chair, our legal officer prepared a report, but those items required by this committee was not itemized. It was not included in her report, so we have not prepared all those requirements, Mr. Chair. But we will comply, Mr. Chair.
Thank you if you will comply. But I would like to inform you na yung kami, tinitingnan namin kung ano po yung hinihingi namin sa inyo ng mga dokumento. Nililistan namin. And that is precisely why I'm asking for your compliance this morning in so far as the items that we have promised to submit. Now, you were also required to submit MOU between PNP and CHR. Confirm and submit the correct memorandum of understanding. Did your representative tell you that?
No, Mr. Chair.
And then, what would you do with your representative?
I have to make her explain why she did not include that in her report to me.
Oh, kasi ikaw ngayon ang sumasagot because of his inefficiency.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Tama? Letter E, submit command circulars and operations documentation. You were not also informed of this?
I was not informed, Mr. Chair.
And the PNP was also required to submit inventory of cases filed during drug operations.
Good morning, Mr. Chair. We have already submitted that compliance, Mr. Chair.
Comsec, have they submitted such document? Yung inventory of cases filed during drug operations. Anyway, we'll take your word that you have submitted such. You're an officer and a gentleman, and I'll take your word for it. Letter G, submit relevant police documentation from the PNP detailing the to provide implementation procedures and definitions of terms like neutralization and negation in CMC-16 series of 2016.
Mr. Chair, from the Directorate for Operations, I was informed by our legal officers that the CMCs and all those documents that have been required were already submitted to the COMSEC last hearing, Your Honor. Thank you.
Thank you. Colonel Bakay or General Bakay was requested to provide the updated police manual. Particularly changes made to in inquest proceedings. Are you aware of this?
During the last hearing, Mr. Chair, the same was discussed, but I was of the impression that it was already settled insofar as the inquest, the clarification on the inquest procedure being implemented by the PNP is concerned, Mr. Chair, so I did not submit any written clarification on the matter, Mr. Chair.
So, could you submit it the next hearing?
Yes, Mister. We have it, Mister.
Thank you. You're supposed to submit detailed case reports. Submission of detailed records of the 61 police officers who died during operations and the corresponding 6,000 cases.
Yes, Mr. Chair. It's with the Secretariat, which we have submitted, Mr. Chair. There are five items on that report, Mr. Chair.
Thank you. You were also required to provide a list of the cold cases involving police officers, their circumstances, and the periods of incidents.
That was with CIDG, I believe, sir. The cold cases.
Yeah.
Director CIDG, sir.
Your Honor, we will submit that requirements.
You will submit?
Yes, Your Honor.
And when would that be?
As soon as we will get it in our record, sir, then immediately we will submit it to the CONSEC.
Thank you. There was a requirement by the Honorable Manuel for the PNP to provide clearance forms for certain police operations.
Your Honor, may I be clarified if it's a clearance form or coordination form? Because those forms were already incorporated in the ACMC with respect to campaign against illegal drugs, Your Honor.
You have complied with this?
Yes, Your Honor.
Thank you.
Congressman Jacob.
Yes.
Is this what you submitted to us today? General Baca, you're the signatory of this third meeting of the House for the Committee on Human Rights. You have submitted. Is this the CMC included?
No, Mr. Chair. That is the data on first is the number of police of deaths, DIPO, right, in police operations for. Covering the period of the time of the former president, Mr. Chair. Second is the number of deaths, number of cases, number of deaths. Third is the cases, status of the cases. Fourth is the number of policemen died, who also died during these police operations. And the last, I believe, is the status of high-profile cases during these drug operations like the Kiandel Santos, etc., Mr. Chair. That's the contents of the report I have submitted, Mr. Chair.
Okay, go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. In the last hearing also, Mr. Chair, there was a show cause order issued for Police Major General Romeo Karamat for non-attendance, and I think he is present today, Mr. Chair.
He is...
Now, invitations were also sent to former PNP Chief Vicente Danao, former Solicitor General Jose Calida, Director De Limos of the National Bureau of Investigation, a certain Vicente de Guzman III. Mr. Chair, may I know if the invitations were sent, and may I know if they are present in today's hearing?
Comsec.
Good morning, sir. I replaced Director De Lemos. I just assumed my duty as the director of the NBI. Assistant Director Vicente de Guzman III is present, and other officers of the NBI.
I beg your pardon, Director.
I just assumed as the new director of the NBI, sir.
We need the presence of Mr. Vicente de Guzman III.
Present, po, sir.
Present,
sir. He is present, sir.
Thank you. About former NBI Director De Lemos?
Wala na po siya. Ako na nga po ang pumalit.
No. Siya po ang personal na kailangan po namin.
Oh, I'm
kasi
sorry.
Siya po ang sasagot ng mga katanungan ng mga members ng committee.
I think he is no longer attending. Pero sasabihan ko po sa next hearing ko.
Is he a private person now, Director?
Yes.
Sir?
A private person po si De Lemos?
penalty?
Private person na po siya? O?
Yes, sir. Sa ngayon. Sa ngayon po.
But you could be able to contact him, no?
Yes, sir. Okay. We can contact him.
Did Comsec, did he submit a letter to explaining his absence?
No, Your Honor, he did not.
But pursuant to our rules, Mr. Chair, if the invitation is not or was received and the committee did not receive any explanation for his non-attendance, I think the next course of actions is to issue a show cause order. May I move, Mr. Chair, that a show cause order be issued?
There's a motion, show cause order be issued on?
Former NBI Director Luigi De Lemus.
Can we include the others who were invited but they were not able to explain their absence?
About former Solicitor General Jose Calida.
Is there anyone who would like to tell us what happened to SG Jose Calida? Anyone? And there's no letter of explanation, correct? And then who else?
And former PMP Chief Vicente Danao.
Wala din, no?
He's not also present, Your Honor. They were the PNP Lula was able to send the invitation, but there was no reply from him.
May also move so that we will be following the protocol of our rules and legislative inquiry. May also move that we issue a show cause order.
So there's a motion to issue a show cause order on General Danao, former Director De Lemos, and former Solicitor General Jose Calida. Meron ba ba? Na iba? No, tatlo lang sila. No?
Yep. Yes, Mr.
There's a motion.
Second motion.
Second motion. Move seconded that these people will have the show cause order to appear for this committee. Is there any objection? No objection. Same is approved.
Mr. Chair, in the last hearing, we were also supposed to invite certain personalities, former NBI Director Guerran, to clarify the categorization of the 16,355 homicide cases referenced in the year-end report. Did we send an invitation to subject persons?
Wala.
But how about Patrolman Jeremiah Dibangayan? Wala rin. Wala.
I believe there is none, sir.
How about the four policemen? Police Senior Inspector Emil Garcia, PO3 Alan Formilesa, PO1 James Agarao, and PO1 Melchor Navisaga, who were allegedly involved in the Payatas operation under then Colonel Patay's command.
Yes, sir. Yes, Your Honor, the committee has sent invitations to them, and PO1 James Agarao is now present.
Okay. How about the others? Are they present in today's hearing? Present? Okay,
May we get only their names, Your Chair? Present. He was the only one who responded to the roll call, sir.
Oh, where is Patrolman Agarao? And then you are?
Major Garcia.
No, na-promote na siya.
Mr. Emil Garcia po.
Ha?
Emil Garcia.
Okay. So, you are now a major, ha? Oh, you have been promoted.
Yes.
That's good.
Mr.
How about Alan Formilesa? You may be seated, please. Thank you. Andiyan ba siya? Wala siya. Okay. Okay, there's no letter of explanation, no?
None, sir.
Oh.
Melchor Navisaga, sir.
Melchor Navisaga. Is he here? Wala din. All right. Wala din. Okay. Itong ibang ito. All right. We have received the letters from the former solicitor, from the former Secretary of Justice, Minato Guevara. Of course, we have Police General Karamat with us here today. And thank you for coming over. Then we have Attorney Arnel Escobal, the Police Major General, ay sumulat din sa atin. We have Major General Omega Jairi, former director.
Fidel, sir.
All right. We have Police Renante Solomon, who said that he is under medical treatment. Dennis Apal, also. All right.
May I proceed, Mr. Chair?
Yes.
For those people who are absent without any cause or any excuse letter submitted for their absence, may I move that we issue a show cause order for these people?
There is a motion to give show cause order to these people that have been invited without any explanation. Is there any second?
Mr. Chair? See.
Yes.
Mr. Chair, yes. I'd like to include sana si nandito si Colonel Patay.
Yung tatanungin next yun eh.
Ah, okay. Oh. So next. I second the motion, Mr. Chair.
In move and seconded that these people that have been mentioned should be given show cause order. Is there any objection? No objection whatsoever. I think it's approved.
Mr. Chair, may I know if Colonel Lito Patay was invited to today's hearing?
Yes, Your Honor.
And is he present today?
He is not also present, Your Honor.
So, because in the minutes of the last hearing, Colonel Lito Patay was required to provide police reports and records covering the period from July 2016 to September 2017 concerning drug-related operations and killings. He was also required to submit the names and service records of officers he brought from Davao, including their current status, whether active, retired, AWOL, or dismissed. And last but not least, he was required to provide detailed reports covering the period from July 8, 2016 to September 23, 2017. And the reports include the number of incidents, operations conducted, and names of officers involved. So, Mr. Chair, since he's not present today, in spite of the invitation, and did not, shall we say, comply with what was required of him, may I move that we also issue a show cause order for Colonel Patay?
There is a motion.
I second the motion, Mr. Chair.
And seconded that Colonel Patay should appear, and he was at table too. So we're going to give him a show cause order. Any objection? Hearing none, so it's approved.